어떻게 하면 한국어를 배울 수 있을까요? 제가 왜 한국어를 배우게 됐는지, 어떻게 배웠는지, 여러분도 어떻게 하시면 배울 수 있는지 이 비디오를 통해서 이 질문에 대해서 이야기해 보겠습니다. 잘 부탁합니다. 여러분 반갑습니다. 여러분의 언어 코치 아단선생님입니다. 언어는 어떻게 배우면 좋은지 더 재미있게 배울 수 있는 비결, 방법을 알려드리려고 할 건데요. 자, 여러분 준비되셨나요? 오늘 비디오 시작합시다. Alright guys, that was my quick introduction in Korean, but the rest of the video I will do it in English. If you want to see me speaking more in Korean, you can check out these videos or check out the links in the descriptions. This video is a part 3 of a 5-part series on how I became a polyglot and how you can too, if that's what you're interested in. In the previous videos, I talked about how I learned English and Japanese. My fourth and most proficient language is Korean, 한국어. In this video, I will first talk about why I learned it, how I learned it, and give you guys some actionable hints on how you guys can learn it too. So let's go. So part 1, why did I learn Korean? There are two reasons for this. Reason number 1 is I worked with Korean people, with Korean engineers. My first contact with real life Koreans was in 2008, when I was doing some Japanese interpreting work in Mexico to help build a factory. There were two teams, a Japanese team and a Korean team in charge of this project. I was part of the Japanese team, but I was working alongside the Korean team as well. The Korean team only spoke Korean, and even though they were right there in Mexico, they would breathe and live using only Korean, thanks to an interpreter that was helping them perform their work with the Mexican workers. This was crazy fascinating to me because I was exposed to the language every day and understood nothing. After a while though, this started to bother me. Luckily though, I had this cute little phrase book which I picked up in Japan that had some Korean phrases in it, and I tried using it on the engineers without learning any of the foundations for the language. This is what happened.
So I heard Japanese was like Korean. How could this be? I got this. Oh, Mr. Jung! Ah, listen to this.
안녕하세요.
Oh, Adan, you study Korean. Good, good. Very difficult language.
당신은 한국말을 할 수 있습니까?
뭐라고?
저는 일본을 가고 싶습니다.
아니, 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 아다나. 발음이 좀 일본 사람 같아.
김치 좋아합니까?
아니 아니 아다나 아나 노노노노 노트 김치니?
김치
노트 김치니?
똑바로 말해. 화장실이 어디에 있습니까?
화장실은 그쪽에 있는 것 같은데.
오빠 강남스타일 오?
지금 2008년인데?
무궁화 꽃이 피었습니다.
삼겹살 먹으러 가시겠습니까?
발음이 갑자기 좋잖아.
Parlez vous français?
Ah bagay.
Yeah, as you can see, that didn't go too well. But they super appreciated the effort and we became great friends because of that. I would get taught little pieces and bits of Korean here and there. I would eat amazing Korean food every day with them and we bonded for 4 months. But then it was over. Reason number 2, I moved close to a Korea town in the USA. In 2010, I landed a very nice tech job at a Japanese company located in Virginia, USA that required me to use Japanese all of the time. I lived Japanese at work, so my desire to learn the language was not that big anymore. I was mentally satisfied with Japanese. Or so I thought. One day, I was searching around the area and noticed that there was a huge Korean community near me in a city called Annandale. I drove by the place and it was full of Korean restaurants, karaoke bars, shops, you name it, they had it. It was intimidating at first though, so I tried to figure out a way to enter it. I wanted a piece of the action. I searched around online and thankfully they had some meetups going on in that area. This got me super excited. I joined the meetup. I started making friends, language partners, and experiences with the culture that would start to shape my why in the language. This was basically the beginning of me seriously committing to the Korean language. After about 2 or 3 years of being a part of this community, my Korean started to get pretty decent as well. So next, let's talk about the mechanics of what I actually did to learn the language. Part 2. How did I actually learn Korean? First, I took a shortcut. Japanese is very close to Korean. Not just the word order, but the particles, the verb endings, and many of the grammar works in very, very similar ways. Some Japanese speakers or Korean speakers get crazy good at the language in just a couple of months because they are so close to each other. My first thought was to attempt to learn the language with materials for Japanese speakers. This would also strengthen my Japanese at the same time. I bought a book called 驚くほど身につく韓国語from Amazon Japan, which has a dialogue sentence-based approach. It also gave me the foundation on the pronunciation, which I was having trouble in the beginning, as you could see from that skit that I just put previously. Next, I started doing language exchanges frequently. So after joining my local Korean meetup and started to make real Korean friends, as well as other amazing students of the Korean language, I would schedule language exchanges with them. Check out my video right here on how to do language exchanges if you don't know how to do one correctly. After we did our language exchanges, we would also go to local Korean restaurants and I would be exposed to the Korean culture all from within the USA. I also started learning about AJAT. AJAT is basically short for all Japanese all the time. It is a methodology that gives you the mindset on how to learn languages by yourself on the internet, without really needing to travel and live in your target language's country. I had already done this for Japanese and English previously without actually knowing it, but seeing someone else achieve similar results in far less time sparked my curiosity and I started picking up new distinctions that improved my language learning methodology. Because of this, I started to strategically do immersion with online media in Korean as well. So I also encourage you to check out Matt vs. Japan's refold method as it is a refined version of what AJAT is. I joined my local Korean church. So once I was already pretty comfortable with the Korean language thanks to my meetups and training, I decided to take my immersion to the next level and I joined my local Korean church. Here I would basically live and breathe Korean. I would pray in Korean, do Bible studies in Korean, worships in Korean, volunteer service in Korean, you name it, I was doing it. All the friends I met here were amazing souls as well, and they all helped me improve and reach a whole new level in the language. Next, and finally, I went to Korea. After I finally got comfortable with the Korean language, I went to Korea. I had already visited the country before once, but I didn't speak the language at all that time. Now though, being actually proficient in the language, going back to Korea was incredibly fun and rewarding. I would get to visit my friends that I had met in the US or Mexico. They introduced me to their friends and family. I traveled all over the country, and I even did some mini home stays with many of them. This made Korean an amazing and enriching part of my life. Korea is such a cool country. I took hip-hop lessons there, made amazing friends that I consider family now, and consume a ton of Korean content right now because it is just so well made. In short, it is amazingly fun. So, part 3, the final part, how can you learn Korean as well? If my story opened up your mind a little bit, I want to summarize with some actionable tasks for you to go get started in your Korean learning journey. Pick learning material that has a clear start and a clear finish. I see a lot of people that are munching a bit here on an app or on a little bit bits and pieces of information here and there without a clear start or end. So the problem is that they never actually finish any considerable block of knowledge in the language. As a result, they don't see any progress and they stop before they have built a solid habit in the language. Don't be that person. Commit yourself to something simple and finish it. then go to the next level and finish that. Rinse and repeat. For example, make it your goal to learn the Korean alphabet first, Hangul. Make sure that the material that you choose has clear audio and a ton of exercises as well, so you can train what you're studying. I recommend the following materials for English speakers. Korean from Zero, Korean Grammar and Use. If you are already someone that speaks Japanese and are comfortable with the language, you're in luck. These are some great books that have helped me to learn Korean through Japanese. Check the links in the description for all the material that I have mentioned. Amazon Japan ships to many parts of the world, so you might want to try this if this is a path that you're interested in going through. Immerse yourself in the language. Consistently watch movies and media, dramas, music, variety shows, news. Take it all in. Korean really has some extremely fun content. Learn to find people online to practice with. Do this as soon as you can. My favorite apps for this are HelloTalk and iTalki. Check them out. If you have a Korean community close to you or a meetup, go check it out as well. Restaurant, a supermarket, anything related to Korea, go and check it out. The point is to weave the Korean culture into your lifestyle slowly. I'll leave a link to my Korean community in Annandale if you're in the DMV area in the USA. They also do online meetups as well now, so you can access it from basically anywhere in the world. And tell them that adansensei sent. All right, amigos, question of the day. How are you learning Korean, or how did you already learn it? Leave us a comment with your opinion in the box below. All right, 여러분, that was all for today. This was adansensei, your personal language coach. Korean is an incredibly fun and rewarding language. It has definitely changed my life for the better, and I'm sure it will enrich your life too. Commit yourself to learning it. Start small, be consistent, enjoy the process, and I'll see you in the next video.